time for the Mets game. Hollywood Squares Hour with the Master Mesh, William Christopher. From Duck Factory, Teresa Ganzer. From Simon & Simon, Tim Reed. Robert Goddard. Fanny Flagg. And the stars of the Mets game Hollywood Squares Hour, Gene Rayburn and John Bowman.
Thank you.
There we go.
Welcome.
Thank you.
All right. Hold everything.
Hold everything?
Is this a homogenous group? No? I mean, are you all from one organization? No.
The human race.
So you're a heterogeneous group, right. From everywhere. Mostly tourists?
No!
Well, you don't have to get angry with me. I'm just inquiring. Because we haven't had every seat occupied in a long time. You must be a big draw.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, you got one on your side there.
Are
you
at least we're a heterogeneous group here.
We are a heterogeneous group.
We are.
Right. All right, let's begin, shall we, by greeting our two players over here. We have Debbie Head and William Cathers. Hello there.
Hi.
How did you get acquainted?
Hi.
Debbie, we'll hear about you first.
Well, I'm a headhunter in Los Angeles. I work for my mom's employment agency, and my husband has a candy store in our same building. Keeps me sweet.
Really?
Yeah.
You work in an employment agency, a headhunting employment,
right.
And your name is Head?
I know.
Isn't that strange?
I know, and I married into it.
And you're married. What was your maiden name?
Chrysler.
Chrysler. What kind of car do you drive?
Not a Chrysler.
A Buick?
No, an Audi.
An Audi?
Mm-hmm.
I'm an innie.
You drive a German car, a foreign car?
I know.
Leave the stage immediately.
We're spelled different, our last
name. Oh, all right.
Okay.
Hello, William.
Hello.
Did I say your name correctly?
Yes, you did.
What do you do to keep your body and soul together?
Well, I'm originally from Columbus, Ohio. Got a good start there. And after college, I went to Europe for a couple of years and played professional basketball over there.
Oh,
and then basketball fans. And then I returned to Los Angeles. I'm now a freelance writer.
What countries did you play in?
I played in Italy and I played in Austria.
Did you learn a language or anything like that? Were you there a long time?
I played one season in each, and you pick up a little bit of the language. Where's the bathroom? Pass the butter.
Right. Gotcha.
Where's the next train to Munich?
Yes.
Things like that.
How do you say that?
Where's the next train to Munich?
I gotcha. He learned a lot of German, didn't he? It would be a good show. All right. How tall are you?
6'2".
6'2". Let's begin the match game. We'll play three rounds. The winner will challenge the returning champion on Hollywood Squares for a chance to win up to $30,000. Debbie won the toss. She begins.
B.
Here we go. Joan Rivers' mouth is so big. Wow. When she has a checkup, instead of using a tongue depressor, the doctor has to use a blank. I remember you are all noted for your humorous bents.
Our humorous beats?
Bent.
Okay.
All right. You ready, Miss Fanny?
Yes.
Okay. Hello, Debbie.
Hi.
Joan Rivers' mouth is so big, when she has a checkup, instead of using a tongue depressor, the doctor has to use a blank.
2x4.
2x4 is all right. That's okay. Girl after my own heart with a 2x4. What do you say?
Wo ist der nächste Zug nach München?
I
said a tennis racket.
Oh. A tennis racket. That's good.
Sorry.
Not a groaner. Not a bad one. Fanny.
Good.
This one is for Elizabeth Taylor, who takes it pretty bad from Joan. I said a canoe paddle.
A canoe paddle, hey. Good.
See, I'm talking real big mouth, so I said shovel.
A shovel. So we have three good answers up in the upper tier. Debbie's answer was good. So far, we've had four good answers. John?
My mouth is so big.
Two shovels so far. I'm really surprised that a 2x4 hasn't come up here.
Nope. It still hasn't a spatula.
Spatula's good. Robert, you look depressed.
Well, you'd be depressed, too. Bill's two laughs up on everybody. He's not even playing the game yet. What is the game?
Come on.
What did you say, Debbie?
2x4.
That comes out to Schwei by Fear.
Yay!
That a way to go, Robert. All right, listen carefully now, William. You're up to bat. Weird Willie read the book Act Out Your Fantasies.
Ooh.
And then he went out and married his blank. Weird Willie. Here we go, William. Weird Willie read the book Act Out Your Fantasies. Then he went out and married his blank.
Former school teacher.
Former school teacher. You only have one, but I wouldn't worry if I were you. All right. Bill, what do you say?
Well, I'm not going to say where is the next train to Munich again. I did that once. But I thought former school teacher is good. And I'm very close to that. I said babysitter.
Babysitter.
Or something.
Now, babysitter is good.
One does have fantasies.
Anything oddball like that, because after all, his name is Weird Willie.
Yes. William, you're absolutely right, because most people have crushes on their teachers. I was close. I said pet duck.
Right. That's a good one. Tim?
You did say fantasies. We're talking
fantasies.
Strange.
Yeah, Act Out Your Fantasies is the name of the book, and then he went
this
out.
This does not reflect on me, but I said horse.
His horse.
Uh-oh.
He loved his horse. All right, John.
Well, this is absolutely a match with former school teacher, because I hate to say this to you, Mrs. Warhoftig, but you, in fact, were a dog.
If she's watching, you have wounded her deeply.
She's probably long since gone. It was sixth grade.
Oh, all right. Teresa.
Well, originally I would have matched with Fanny, because I wrote duck, and then I changed it to mother.
Aha!
Uh-huh. Oh, yes. It's weird.
Act out your fantasies. That's weird.
That's fantastic.
We called weird, great. And that's what we got. Robert?
Former school teacher, eh?
Yeah.
I can see why you only lasted 1 year in each place. I said he married his dog.
Married his dog. So, score is 1-0. Debbie's ahead at the end of round one. Round two coming up right after this for you. Here we go. Hey. Telephone contest time. Here we go again. Somebody in television land will win $5,000. Possibly, and also a chance to appear on an NBC soap opera. Now, we've made our selection at random from the postcards you've sent in to us, and today our home contestant is Charlene Snaufer, and she's from Salome, Arizona. Let's find out if Charlene is there. Are you there, Charlene?
Yeah, hi, Gene. I'm here.
Fine. What's the weather like in Arizona?
Very hot, about 103 today.
Oh. Well, listen, stay hot. I hope you win the money and the appearance on an NBC soap opera. If you don't do that, the least you'll get is $500. Because
Your
name is picked, we're giving you $500. Are you happy about that?
Fantastic.
That is fantastic. All right. Congratulations for that. Now, our production assistant has been on the line with you, and she's given you the names of the stars who are on today's show.
Right.
We ask you now to make a decision and tell us which of the stars you choose for the head-to-head telephone match.
John Bauman.
All right, John will write his answer down, and I'll get a verbal response from you after he has finished writing. So, don't give me an answer until I call for it, okay?
Okay.
All right, hold on a second while I get the card out of my pocket. Hold on, everybody. Don't nobody move. It's in here somewhere. Oh, there it is. All right, you ready? Here it is. Blank Hour, H-O-U-R. Did you hear me?
Yes, Blank Hour. Oh.
That's what I said, Blank Hour, H-O-U-R.
Yes. This is going to take a second.
Are you thinking?
Yeah, I'm kind of stuck, but I guess I got one.
Have you got one?
Yeah.
Don't say it yet. Okay. All right. Charlene, John is ready.
Okay.
It's up to you to collect the money to match him. How do you fill in that blank?
Happy.
Happy Hour. Okay, Charlene. I see you got a brisk round of applause from all the winos in the studio audience here. They think that's a pretty good answer. Now, if you match John, you collect the $5,000 and a chance to appear on an NBC soap opera. John, show and tell if you please.
It's an awfully good answer, and it's just that we're sitting here, and I was afraid of getting this, so I wrote it. The Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour, which is the name of our own show!
Oh, I'm sorry, Charlene.
You didn't think he'd do it.
See, because...
What's that?
I thought of that, but I didn't think he'd do it.
Well, he did it.
Well, it was fun.
Right. No, well, I'm glad. You've got a good spirit and an attitude. And if you want to get the venom out of your system, just write directly to John Bauman, NBC, 3000 West Alameda. Thank
Thanks,
you very
Jim.
Much, Charlene Snelfer. Bye. Okay. Shazam.
What?
Disappear. Yeah. Away you go. Thank you. All right, let's carry on here with round two. Are you ready? Debbie, you won the, you're ahead, 1-0, so that means you'll have to go first.
Okay, I'll try B again.
B again, everyone except one person will play. That's Robert, the perfect person who matched in the previous round. Mike said, I got out of the Army because I had flat feet. Private Dumb Donald said, I knew I did something wrong. I told them I had a flat blank. All right. Here we go, Debbie. Mike said I got out of the Army because I had flat feet. Private Dumb Donald said I knew I did something wrong. I told him I had a flat blank.
Well, I think this is appropriate. Head.
Flat head.
Yeah.
Flat head. Hey, flat head. H-E-A-D. What do you say?
Well, I was in the Army, and I had to know something about this. Well, I said head.
Yay! Flat head. I think it's really weird that she got this question in the view of the fact that her surname is Head. And she's a headhunter.
Of course.
She is.
Finish the sentence, Gene. Finish the sentence.
She's a headhunter.
She's
that's a
head
personnel
hunter.
Agency.
Her name is Head.
That means they look for executives, high-powered executives.
Well, yeah. You know, I'm so sorry. I. Brain.
Hey.
You're close, Spanny.
Head and brain do not match.
But would you be out of an army with a flat head? I know a lot of flat-headed army men.
Right. Name
well,
names.
I couldn't go against the old headhunter, so I said head.
Yeah! There you go.
All right.
Yeah, I was about to write a flat Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour, but I changed my mind and I said head instead.
Well, Debbie. Teresa?
I said a flat tire.
Flat tire. That's good.
Thank you for making it.
All right. Now, we go over here to William's second round question, which says, Gloria said, I hate being married to a Broadway actor. After we get romantic, he makes me blank. All right, Tim, here we go. William. Gloria said, I hate being married to a Broadway actor. After we get romantic, he makes me blank.
Applaud.
Applaud. Good. Applause, applause. Is that a smile on your face?
Well, it just amuses me. I said, take a curtain call.
A curtain call.
I've worked on Broadway. I know.
All right. Yes?
William, I said, applaud.
Applaud. All right. 4-1 the score. Tim?
Well, I said, clap. Can we?
That's it. Yeah. I didn't hear the dinger loud and clear. May we have, thank you very much. I thought I heard a buzz. John?
1, 2, 3, applaud!
He's catching up to you. Teresa?
1, 2, 3, 4, applaud.
Uh-huh. 4-4. Robert?
Now you see, William, I'm trying to help you. But you keep going for the laugh. I don't happen to see anything wrong or funny about applause after I give a good performance, especially in that arena. However, I said applaud.
You did. Now, at the end of round two, the tables are turned. He's now ahead by one, and the third and final round right after this. Well, that was a good one. Here we go with the third and final round. William, you're ahead. You go first.
I'll try B.
B. This is for your benefit only, Bill.
I hope I benefit from this.
William to William. Colonel Connie said. I beg your pardon. Colonial Connie said. Colonial Connie said.
Right.
I think Ben Franklin is into pain. During last night's lightning storm, he tied the kite string to his blank. All right, he's ready, William.
Think so.
Colonial Connie said, I think Ben Franklin is into pain. During last night's lightning storm, he tied the kite string to his blank.
His tush.
His tush.
It's not easy to do, you know.
That's very hard to do, especially if you're alone and don't have anybody to help you.
There's so many choices.
Yes.
Well, I said nose.
Nose.
The nose, right. Nose.
So that's what I would have said.
William stays at 5. Debbie is at 4. She needs 1 to tie and 2 to win.
Let's see.
This is a very tight game. Let's see what happens. Dumb Donald was so dumb. You gotta get together. Get your act together if you want to go on the road with me. He took his food stamps and blanked them. That's how dumb he was. Fanny and Teresa are the only two away. Teresa's ready. Fanny is finishing up. And here we go, Debbie. Dumb Donald was so dumb, he took his food stamps and blanked them.
Ate them.
That's good. He ate his food stamps, Fanny.
Do you believe that?
Can you imagine somebody so dumb he ate his food stamps?
But they're good.
They are.
A little salt and pepper.
Tie score now.
What?
Eight. Right there on that mark. Hey, William, it was a pleasure to meet you.
Nice meeting you.
I'm going to send some gifts to William Cavers, ladies and gentlemen, from the match. Hey, 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 hey. Hallelujah. You ready? All right. Now we're going to switch to Hollywood Squares, and we're going to bring on 3 more celebrities. John and I will trade places. A lot of excitement coming along yet, so don't go away. We'll be right back.
A member of our studio audience will receive Whirlpool's microwave oven with microcomputer push-button control. Program all cooking cycles, times, and power with the touch of your fingertip. Convenient defrost guide and bi-level cooking rack furnished by Whirlpool. It's time for more of The Match Game. Hollywood Squares, our whip from Gimme a Break, Kari Michelson. Bruce Ball. Marilyn Michael.
and taking over, the star of the Hollywood Squares, John Bauman.
But what time is the next train to Munich? Well, we have a couple of minutes to find out, and then we'll be right back to play Hollywood Square.
And now, John Bauman and the Hollywood Square.
Thank you, and here she is, Debbie Head, who's certainly proved that she's got a good head on her shoulders. She made it through the match game and on to Hollywood Squares. Welcome to three brand new celebrities. Bruce Baum.
How you doing?
Marilyn Michaels.
Hi.
And Kari Michelson. No relation.
No. Are we related, Marilyn? No.
Okay, Mr. Baum, it's great to have you here once again. And I would like to point out, since it is our last show of this week, that Bruce is going to be appearing in some comedy clubs pretty soon, right?
Right, I'll be in Niles, which is like Warren Youngstown Niles, a place called The Club. All the other places are A Club. This is The Club.
Is that in Chicago?
No, it's in Niles, like Ohio. And the Pittsburgh Comedy Club in Pittsburgh, oddly enough.
That's a good place for it.
And I just learned how to do this, an upside-down handstand.
Well, Debbie Head, you don't have to do an upside-down handstand, but you do have to zip over here with me to play Hollywood Squares. Here we go. And Diana Smith did not do an upside-down handstand yesterday, but she did stand us pretty much on our heads with $22,075 in her purse. Now, it's only your second day, so why don't you just tell us everything we ever want to know about your life, but we're afraid to ask once again.
Married for 7 years. I have two children, Matthew and David, and my husband's in the beef business.
Oh.
And I'm just a housewife.
Where's the beef business?
Where's the beef business?
It's right
really
here.
Weird.
And so is the Hollywood Squares. Let's play this until we hear the time's up bell business. Whoever's at that point goes on to play Supermatch, which can be worth up to $30,000, and you won $20,000 of those dollars yesterday. First game's worth $100, $25 for every square. Diana Smith, take a good look at these bozos and pick a star.
Fanny, please.
Fanny Flag.
Bozos.
Fanny, oh, this was for the other guy. While living in Italy, exercise expert Richard Simmons once starred in a TV commercial. Did he appear as a Jewish mother or a dancing meatball?
He appeared as a Jewish mother.
Eat, son, eat.
So like Richard.
She says Richard Simmons was a Jewish mother.
Sam, I disagree.
While living in Italy, exercise expert Richard Simmons starred as a dancing meatball. Yes, you're right to disagree, and you get the first square. Right off the bat, you show that you're a good player, a dancing meatball. I guess that was the pilot for the show that he did here, I believe. Debbie Head, your move for an O.
Okay, I'll go with Robert.
Okay, Robert Donner.
You seem confused.
If
or
you
surprised
had...
that I'm here. Which is it?
If you had water in your veins instead of blood, would it all run out if you cut yourself? Or would the skin quickly seal itself up?
You think you're going to throw me with this, don't you? Well, if I was in the tropics, it'd all run out. If I was in the South Pole, none of it had run out.
You sure can't find the subtleties in these questions.
I listen to the questions, John. I pay attention to what you say.
Do you have an answer?
Yes, I do. I'm in Burbank. So if it was water, it'd run all out.
Okay, he says, if you had water in your veins instead of blood, you cut yourself, it would all run out. What do you say, Debbie?
Absolutely, it would all run out.
Absolutely, she agrees, and in fact, all the water would run out of your body, yes. You are right, and you get the square. Well, Diana Smith, pick a star for another X.
Gene.
Okay, Gene.
Ready.
Did Henry Ford drive a Rolls Royce? Or did he always stick to Fords?
He always stuck to Fords. He had a one-track mind.
Agree or disagree, Diana?
I disagree.
Henry Ford drove a Rolls-Royce. You are right to disagree, and you get that score as well. Quality is job one, and Henry knew quality when he saw it. We're going to be back to complete a $100 game right after these messages. Join us.
Stay tuned for more of the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour. Now back to John Bauman and the Hollywood Squares.
Now, I mean, we have had a run of really good players on this show, and I think we've got another two right here because you're disagreeing at the right times, you're really thinking about the questions, and you're playing very well. Debbie, your turn for an O.
I think I'll go with Tim.
Okay. Interesting maneuver.
Yes, it
no,
was.
Too late. Can't take it back. Can't take it back. She could have gone to Kari to block. Tim Reed, overnight yes. The cucumbers you're growing have gone from 2 inches to 4 inches. Is this normal, or are you living too close to Three Mile Island?
I want the formula, I know that. I would say this is normal.
He says that's normal for those cucumbers. What do you say, Debbie?
I'll disagree.
It is normal for those cucumbers. So you should have agreed with Tim, and your opponent gets that square, which helps you out a bit more, Diana Smith, in addition to her strategic error. Actually, you would have won the game had she gone where she really wanted to go. Where would you like to move?
William to win, please.
Okay.
Makes sense. I hope.
Let's see. What famous person's memoirs are entitled R.N.? Is it Florence Nightingale or Richard Nixon?
Well, I don't think there's too much to debate. I can't imagine. I believe it's Mr. Nixon.
It says Richard Nixon's memoirs were titled R.N. What do you say, Diana, for the game?
I agree.
Richard Nixon's memoirs were titled R.N. You're right to agree, you get the square, and you win the first game. It's a lovely book. 18.5 pages are missing. You have won the $100 game. Congratulations, Diana Smith. However, we will zip those X's and the solitary O off of the board. Debbie, you got off to a real good start, but then you kind of flagged.
I know.
Pick yourself up and start all over again in a $200 game.
I'll start with Kari.
Kari Michelson from Give Me a Break. According to the American Dermatology Association, does the average teenager have clear skin or zits?
Okay. The average teenager, I think, makes many visits to the dermatologist and does have what you said. I'm not going to say it.
We established yesterday that Kari is, in fact, 22, although she looks much younger, but she does
remember.
See,
my skin, I don't have any of those things.
Right. She thinks she remembers that the average teenager
has... But I'm not a teenager anymore. Okay.
Zits. Agree or disagree, Debbie?
I agree.
Yes, the average teenager does have zits, and I'm sure the average teenager could have told you that. You get that square. Diana Smith, your move for an X.
Fanny, please.
Fanny.
Yes, we'll
in the center it. Square. Your dog, Bob, never laughs at your jokes. Does Bob just have no sense of humor? Or don't dogs ever laugh?
Strange you should ask me this. I have a Doberman Pinscher, and he laughs quite often. Dogs are capable of laughing.
So Bob, this mythical dog, just has no sense of humor, she says. Agree or disagree, Diana?
I agree.
Dogs don't laugh. No, you should have disagreed with Fanny in that case. I don't know what her dog is doing when she thinks he's laughing, but your opponent gets that square nonetheless. Fanny is crying, and Debbie is smiling. Pick a star.
I'll go with Gene for the win.
Okay, this would give you the game in the lead. Which came first, Gene, the R-Gang comedies or canned shrimp?
Aha. Very interesting question. Let's see. Our gang goes back to the teens prior to 1920. And I don't know whether they were canning shrimp then. That's a hard one. I would say that our gang comedies came before canned shrimp.
Okay. Agree or disagree for the game, Debbie?
I agree.
canned shrimp came first. You should have disagreed with D. Your opponent gets that square and blocks you. 1867 for the canned shrimp, 1922 for the Argang comedy. Okay, we're going to be back to finish what has become quite a thrilling $200 game after these messages. See ya. $225 for the champ, $75 for the challenger, but it's a $200 game, and challenger could easily forge from behind here. Diana, it is your move for an X.
Robert, please.
Okay, Mr. Donner?
Yes.
According to the West Point Fitness and Diet Book, if you don't want to jog, is it okay to skip down the street instead? Or should you avoid skipping in public?
Am I a cadet?
You know, that's a pretty good question. What do you think here, guys? We really need research on this. Well, is it just anyone who reads the book, or is it designed for cadets? Anyone who reads the book. For a cadet. It
for
is specifically
cadet?
For a cadet.
If a cadet cannot jog, he should not skip. And he shouldn't wait either.
He says that cadets should not skip in public. What do you say, Diana?
I agree.
It is okay to skip in public. You should have disagreed. All right, soldier. You got the square, Debbie question. Head. And that puts you in quite a commanding position
strange
in this game.
Army.
Pick a star.
Okay, I'll go for Bruce for the win.
Okay.
You don't skip in battle, though, that's for sure.
Can you deduct the cost of a hair transplant on your tax return? I don't know how this question got in your pile, Bruce. I really don't. This is pitiful. Can you deduct the cost of a hair transplant on your tax return, or is that something the IRS does not allow?
Well, my dad happens to be a hair farmer, so I know this answer.
Only if you're an actor.
I don't think cosmetic surgery is allowable. They wouldn't allow it for, no, I'm going to say that you can't, a cosmetic surgery is not deductible.
Agree or disagree, Debbie, for the game.
I agree.
Surprises me, too. The cost of a hair transplant is deductible, so your opponent gets that square. And now we have really a very interesting board up there. You got a bunch of options here. Diana, pick a star.
William to win, please.
Yeah, that's what I would do. Okay, this would give you a pretty big lead if you get it. William Christopher, your baby falls asleep right after you feed him. Should you burp him while he's sleeping, or should you let him sleep?
Oh, they're so sweet when they sleep. I think that I've had a couple to burp from time to time, and it's nice for a baby to burp, but it's not necessary, I'm sure. I think if he falls asleep, if he, it's just lovely. Let him sleep.
Says, let that baby sleep. What do you say for the game?
I agree.
Let him sleep. You are right to agree. You get the square and you win the game. Tough champ. Well done. You came from a really disadvantaged position in that game. You got 475 to 100 for Debbie, but there is still time. Take the X's and O's off the board. Start a $300 game with you, Debbie Head.
I'll start with Bruce.
Okay. Try to be efficient. This Chinese art form, Bruce, is over 300 years old. Is it? Assembling cockroach tableaus or dressing cats up to look like people?
Well, I happen to know the cockroach thing. Was that, what was the first one? Was assembling cockroach
tableaus.
Yeah. That's Bulgarian. Everybody knows that. It's definitely, I believe, dressing up cats to look like people.
He says dressing cats up to look like people is the Chinese art form.
Agree
or disagree, Debbie?
I'll agree.
It is assembling cockroach tableaus of actual dead cockroaches. Believe this or not, your opponent gets that. Well, that's very interesting. Diana, it is your move. You are playing X, and you got one up there.
Gene, please.
Gene Rayburn.
Can't believe some of these answers.
The Pope is having dinner at your house. According to Emily Post, should you ask him to say grace, or would that be impolite to the Pope?
I mean, he's in the business. Why shouldn't he?
Yeah. He says you should ask the Pope to say grace. What do you say, Diana?
I agree.
You should ask him to say
Certainly.
Grace. Yes, you're right, Your Grand. You get the square once again. Probably be impolite not to ask him to say grace, I would think. Debbie.
William to block.
Yes.
I block from time to time.
Okay.
I would go so far as to say, you miss this one, it's all over. Does a praying mantis have any bones in his body, or is he boneless?
Well, let's see, what is that? Crustacea insectida? I've forgotten those, the phylums. I used to know that. Well, Andy, no bones. He's an insect. The bones are the outside, that's all.
He says a praying mantis is boneless. What do you say, Debbie, for a critical block?
I'll agree.
A praying mantis is boneless. And you were right to agree. You get the square, and you do block. So, the bell means that time is up. She has done it once again. Diana Smith is our champ. Good for you. Sip yourself right over there. Join Gene. That's set for your shot at potentially $30,000.
We tried.
You did real good, really. This is a very, very, very competitive match. Much more so, I think, than the score indicates. Her total is $125, and her name is Debbie Head, and our thanks to you for playing Match Game Hollywood Squares. Gene, thank you.
Okay, here we are. She's got an even $22,600 at this moment. She could increase it a lot more. We'll find out how much more right after this.
And now, here to play the Super Match is Gene Raver.
Well, we're ready. I guess you're ready, too. Shall we?
Yeah.
All right, good luck to you. You have an even $26,000 now. Let's see how much more you're going to add to it. We polled an audience not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. Blank murder. For giving us the answer they chose most often, you get $1,000. For the second, $500. And for the third, $250. Any three of the nine stars are allowed to offer a little assistance here. Whom do you call on?
John.
Diamond.
This is a tough question, guys. Something murder. I'll say dial M for murder.
All right, there you have one.
Okay.
Robert.
First degree murder.
Fanny.
Mass murder.
So those are the three you have. Dial M, mass murder, and first degree murder. Now, you have to think about this carefully and give us a decision. Do you want to choose one of those or create one of your own?
First-degree murder.
You want first-degree murder.
That's good.
All right. Will the witness please take the stand? Raise your right hand. No, I'm only kidding. First-degree is what she wants. May we see the $250 response? First-degree murder right off the bat.
I don't like mine. Don't look at me. I don't like
mine. That was Robert's answer. What have we got under the $500 one? Dial M is John's. Well, now that's a mystery to me. What could be...
Up there.
What do you think? What?
Bloody. I have bloody, too. I'm not a shot.
Cold-blooded murder?
Mass.
All right. Slide it, Steve.
Who knows?
Bloody murder.
I can't believe it. I had
bloody murder.
I wrote it down. I never dreamed.
Really? Well, anyway, you've got $250. That is yours irrevocably. And now it's time for the head-to-head match with any star of your choosing. And after you've made your decision, the star will reveal a hidden number and will multiply the $250 by that number. And for your sake, since we only got the $250, I do hope you get lucky here and choose the big 3-0. Where do you think it is?
Fanny.
Fanny may have it. One never knows.
Oh, I don't do it now, right?
Yes, you do it now. Oh, you're playing for $2,500. She had a 10. We'll find out later where the big one is. Good luck to you. Here we go. It's blank rash. R-A-S-H. Blank rash. Fanny's ready. Now it's up to you to collect the $2,500 by matching her. What do you say?
Diaper rash.
Well, you have two children, right? Well, that would be something that would be familiar to you. Fanny, she says diaper rash. What do you say?
I have a rash of nerves. Have you ever heard that?
A rash of nerves?
It's a southern expression.
I've heard of skin rash.
Oh, well, I wrote diaper.
You did? Now you've added to your winnings. Good for you. You got $25,350. Really? Well, then I've been giving the wrong figure. I thought she had more than that. All right, $25,350. We'll be back with her and the stars right after this. Now, which of these stars had the big 30 number? Well, if you had a second guess, which one would you say?
Robert.
You would say Robert. All right, stars, all together, ready, set, go. Tim Reed.
Do it all the time.
Tim
would have been
Reed
a good choice, too.
Fanny, did you want to say hello to Mark Breslow? You haven't seen him all
week. Yes. Hey, Marky.
Say hello.
Hi, honey.
He's there. Right. She wanted to know if he was here, and he's our director, and he's up in the booth, but we rarely get to see him.
And listen, he's handsome, stars, too.
Yes, he is. But he's not my type. you were all splendid, and we hope to see you here again sometime. Would you all be willing to come back?
Lonnie's right.
Singly or collectively?
They weren't that enthusiastic, were they?
No.
We want to come back.
Yeah,
we
you
want
guys
to,
are
I'll
right.
be back tomorrow.
Harry, you want
you're
to
okay.
All right. Now, listen, you'll be back here on Monday, right?
Yes.
We'll look forward to seeing you then, and I'm Gene and Rayburn inviting you to come back on Monday.
And I'm John Bauman inviting you to come back on Monday as well, and saying so long for the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour. Good day for you.
A member of our studio audience will receive a beautiful lazy rocker, swivel rocker with the flexible back, quality and comfort furnished by Lazy Boy. This is Rich Jeffries speaking for the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour, a Mark Goodson television production.